Next, we'll talk about advanced workflow in ABBYY FlexiCapture. We'll talk about standard document processing stages and different processing modes. And we'll talk about configurable workflow settings and the customization of processing stages. Here we see a very typical workflow in ABBYY FlexiCapture. Images are ingested in a variety of ways, and then they're recognized. And after recognition, you see here quite a few different verification stages. And typically for poor quality images, data verification is very important. For multi-page documents, you may need to be doing document assembly checks. Verification, of course, is the most important of these stages. The batch integrity check stage is a stage that requires scripting, and you can use the document set capability to do some of what you can do with batch integrity check scripts. And export confirmations are a way to check your data before export. There's some cases where you would be able to lock down field formats and data checks to make sure that your data is good without relying on a human doing this last export confirmation step. So it's not atypical for people to forego these, depending on your circumstances. If you're dealing with just one-page documents, you would likely turn off the document assembly check. There's different processing modes. The automatic mode is also known as an unattended mode, where after ingestion, documents are recognized and exported. And an interactive mode allows verification using kind of our standard capture workflow. And a customized processing mode might have custom queues, and it might have rules that designate from which verification queue data flows and to which verification queues. And as I mentioned before, we do have an unattended workflow schema. This is a list of different choices here with from a drop-down list in ABBYY FlexiCapture workflow tab. So it defaults to the simple workflow schema where you can turn verification stages on and off, but you can't change their order. Whereas in the advanced workflow schema, you can add custom stages, rearrange stages. So there's more that you can do there. And there's a couple of other stages for web capture station. The unattended schema allows you to export without any verification stage. But then it's important to set up some exports. So you want to set up an export for documents without errors. And that's done at the export setup stage. You have the ability with a drop list to select exporting documents without errors or with errors. So you're going to want to set up, in all likelihood, at least two exports. One for documents without errors, and then you want to export your documents with errors to another location, and then to handle documents that are unrecognized at the batch type level, there's an export tab where you can configure the routing of documents that came up unrecognized, and they very well may need to be attended to post-processing. So the idea here is straight through processing, no stopping for verification in FlexiCapture. Another tip is for those documents with errors, you may want to include our XML export because it gives a lot of information about which characters were low confidence, which fields had errors, and that sort. The simple schema, again, doesn't allow you to rearrange stage orders, and all stages except the verification stage are optional. You should note that verification can always be skipped according to document recognition quality. And you can see here some green arrows, some icons that show stage linking, where a certain stage is linked to the previous enabled stage. You also have the option to click this checkbox where you can link to the previous stage on a given stage, where operators won't then be able to send the task to the stage manually. And we can speak for a moment about custom roles. A custom role allows us to create flexible scenarios where users have special permissions as to which documents to process, which stages and operations with both data and tasks are available. And these custom roles can be created when you're setting up project properties or workflow stage properties. And different scenarios for using custom roles: when there's several batch types with the same or slightly different stages to be processed by the same roles, or when you need roles slightly different from those that are predefined. And importantly, if you create custom stages, then you'll be creating custom roles for those stages. Let's move on to discussing custom stage creation. When you create a custom stage, you can create an automatic stage, an interactive stage, or a user type stage. And those stages kind of reflect automatic and interactive what they sound like. So certain stages, such as recognition and export, are automatic. And so to create those stages, you would select an automatic stage. Further, if you want to create a scripted custom stage, that will be an automatic stage. And then it might be very common for you to create custom interactive stages based on a verification step or a data verification step. And the user type custom stage is for web service API utilization. And as I mentioned, one of your options for creating an automatic stage is to create a custom scripted stage. And here you can either do document or batch processing scripts. And there's so much you can do with workflow scripting. And this automatic stage, of course, is not available in the standalone version of FlexiCapture. I've used workflow scripts to export the data before it goes to each queue. So if there's multiple queues, I can tell with a database search where a given form with a given field value, which stage is it in right now. But that's just one of very, very many use cases. Another use case for a custom workflow scripting stage is to do sorting. So you can write script that will sort documents by page number or based on certain field values, etc. And that can allow the automatic reassembly of documents in a batch that came in out of order.